today. A 3,300-year-old stele reveals an extraordinary well drilling activity in Egypt's desert. In this video, we are going to continue our look into the rich ancient treasures and history of Egypt. This time, a 3,300-year-old stele reveals an extraordinary well drilling activity in Egypt's desert. This activity is dated to the third year of the reign of Ramesses II. Egypt is famous for its beautiful ancient monuments and mummies, be it the pyramids of Giza, the mummy of the influential prophetess of Antinopolis, or the temple of Luxor. Ancient Egyptians were carving all the important events over the walls in hieroglyphic script. Today, when the modern humans have successfully deciphered hieroglyphic script, so many discoveries have been made on ancient Egyptian culture. The hieroglyphic script was deciphered through Rosetta Stone, just like the cuneiform script was deciphered through Behistun inscription. By translating an ancient stele which was created in the reign of Ramesses II, also known as Ramesses the Great, we got to know about the extraordinary event of well drilling activity that occurred in the desert over 3,300 years ago. The inscription of Kuban can be regarded as one of the most precious artifacts that have been discovered in the 19th century. This beautiful granite stele, of which the lower part is missing, was discovered in the 1842 in Kuban, the old Baki, about 120 kilometers south of Aswan. It is dated to the third year of the reign of Ramesses II, which corresponds precisely to the year 1277 BC. The king was said to be 21 years old at that time. The Kuban stele at the beginning of his reign constitutes an essential testimony to the royal ideology. The pharaoh is presented as overcoming an obstacle never overcome before. This obstacle is believed to be the water supply for expeditions to the Akheta gold mines. In doing so, Ramesses takes up a theme already exploited during the reign of his father, Seti I, as a report of the inscription of the Temple of Kenais. On the Temple of Kenais, the inscription is written. What testing it is, a road without water. How do travelers manage to remove dryness from their throats? Who quenches their thirst? When the country is so far away and the desert so vast, woe to the thirsty man in this country. Well, I will take care of them. I will give them a way to survive, and they will celebrate my name in the future and years to come. And the next generation will praise me for my valor, because it is I who have shown compassion and kindness to travelers. The king discovered a water point. The stele of Kuban informs that even Seti I had undertaken in vain the drilling of a well on the road to Akheta, but Ramesses II succeeded. The well dug at his command was found by the Russian teams which explored the region of Wadi Alaki during the construction of the big dam, before he was drowned under the waters of Lake Nessa. This beautiful granite stele honors an exceptional event. In the upper part, Ramesses II makes an offering and fumigation respectively to the gods Min of Koptos and Horus of Beki. In the lower register, a hieroglyphic text of 38 lines informs us that Ramesses II, in the third year of his reign, decided to drill wells supplying water to the desert road which ended in the gold mines of Wadi Alaki. He realized that men and beasts that crisscrossed this road were dying of thirst and consequently no longer brought back gold. The viceroy of Nubia directed the digging work on the instructions of the king, which was a great success since the water gushes from the depth of 12 cubits. This stele constitutes an essential testimony to the royal Ramesside ideology. The king, being presented as overcoming an obstacle never overcome before, that of the water supply for the expedition towards the gold mines of Akheta. The lecture of Pharaoh consists of five names. See the first line of the pillar, of which the latter two are included in the cartridge. His name of the king of Upper and Lower Egypt, or coronation name, here known as Osamete Setepenre, and his name of son of Re, or birth name, here known as Ramses Meriamun. Ramesses II made an offering of 2 vases known, or globular wine vases, to the god Min of Koptos. He is clothed with the attributes of the pharaoh: crown, kepresh, ureus, linencloth, bull's tail, and sandals. Ramesses II presents incense to the god Horus of Beki. He is clothed with the attributes of the pharaoh: the crown, kepresh, ureus, loincloth, bull's tail, and sandals. Horus the Beki is a falcon-headed god who presides over the Nubian site where this commemorative stele was found, namely the Kuban. Below translations are taken from the translation stele Royal de Ramesses II. The line-to-line hieroglyphic translation was done by Egyptologist Dr. Bernard Mathieu. A total of 38 lines are present on the stele. The important lines which describe the events of drilling are lines 8, 9, 23, and 32. Let us examine these lines one after another, starting with line 8. On line 8, the inscription is displayed: "One fine day, His Majesty, who sat on the throne, Behidu of Electrum, and appeared with the dried headband, and the two feathers, began to think of the countries from which gold is brought, and reflect on the purpose of drilling." On line 9, as displayed on the text: "Drilling wells on difficult roads due to lack of water. After hearing, there is a lot of gold in the Akheta region, but its route is extremely difficult because of the lack of water." As continued on line 23, "His Majesty then replied to these greats, 'It is absolutely right, whatever you say, my subject. Water has not been extracted from this country since the time of the god, as you have said. I am going to drill a well there to give water every day, like in Upper and Lower Egypt, where the river flows.'" On line 32, as displayed: "Sovereign my lord, everything happens in accordance with what your majesty has said with his own mouth. Water came out 12 cubits to a depth of 4 cubits. Therefore, an extraordinary masterpiece of art that tells us the whole story of the well drilling in the extreme desert. This will be called the very balanced thinking of a king to advance his kingdom. If people continue to die thirsty, then it will be difficult to get the gold, and Ramesses II were well aware of this. Now, that well has sunk under Lake Nessa, but we do not know how many years the passengers must have quenched their thirst with that water. What is your thought on this? Kindly drop it in comment section, and don't forget to like, share, comment, and subscribe to this channel."